Hello guys, the first video of The Inventor. Welcome to my channel where I show you how to make objects that make you brighter, making you more smarter, I guess. Obviously, I'm the inventor, the king of inventors, the king of inventing objects that could potentially kill you, in a way. You can booby trap your house, I'm your man. And today we're going to show you different ways to make tasers. What you're going to need for this first analogy is a high voltage generator. You can buy this online. It's not illegal and comes in many voltages. This is a button component. Again, you can also get this online. What you need here is a battery case component, okay? Now, this is all I had, so you can buy it with different switches and stuff like that, and I do have a battery case to show you how to wire all that up. But the first analogy is button, one of those square batteries, and a high voltage generator. First of all, we need to take rubber tubing off with scissors. If you have any better tools, please do use them. But with the scissors, you've got to be very careful not to cut the whole thing, so it takes very delicate precision. You can bend it and all that, and that will hopefully. There we go. See? Now we need to do this with every single component. Try not to take too much rubber tubing off, because some of it is good, because it protects it from getting damaged. Also, you can add extra wire if you want to make this uber strong so it doesn't break like at the wind on a windy day, like a breadstick. Okay. So now we need to do the positive and negatives and take those rubber tubings off. Now at first it will be a bit hard for a first timer, but eventually you do get used to it. After all, it took me a couple of tries to get used to taking rubber tubing off the wires. Okay, now we need to take the rubber tubing off these. Again, not too very much. Oops. There we go. Now, I've also got some extra wire here, just in case. Now, one negative to... So this, right here, the black wire, needs to go to one of these switches. Now, there's going to be little holes in them, and you're going to poke that wire through, twist it round, and then wrap it round its... What do you call it? Let's call it pole. Gonna wrap it around its pole. There we go. If I had a soldering iron, I would be using it right about now. Fortunately, life's cruel. So, we now need this green wire going through the other gap. Actually, I'm just going to trim it. It's having trouble getting through. And then the red wires, the two red wires, need to be connected together. Now, when you are going to turn this on, these wires right here need to be in line with each other. Now, adding more battery to it will increase the length jump of the electricity. However, what I do want you to be very, very careful of is that when you do turn this on, use a low enough battery so that way when you, if you are electric shocked, the voltage will not make you tense up, which would hold. Obviously, this is on low battery. This battery right here is a 12 volt. So it would be making massive length jumps. Also, it would be a lot more violent. So the closer it gets, obviously, I use the battery for other tests and such as that. So I might have forgot to charge it over the day. But yes, that is one of the ways to make a taser. Oh, it's run out of juice. Oh no, it snapped. Yeah, sorry guys, snapped the wires. Yeah, if you use a soldering iron, that will be less likely to happen, or if you use more wire. Obviously, I didn't. Okay, now, the next analogy on how to do this. But personally, I find this more dangerous, is that it's a switch. So, when you put it on, if you have a high enough voltage, it would tense up your muscles, you won't be able to let go, and whatever you're using it for, you might not be able to switch it off before, well, you die. But, yeah, right, I'm going to be back. I just need a battery case with a switch. And I forgot to get one. Right, where would a battery case that will not kill me? Here we go. Good condition. Now, granted, you can use a hot glue gun to glue all these components together if you want to make a taser. But I'm using these electronics for something else, such as electric shock gloves. Extendable batons with tasers at the end, knives with tasers at the end, with a battery case at the end so it heats up as well, so when you're stabbing the wound, you can electrocute them and, you know. Anyway, back to work. So, green wire, some of the wire came off. Now, green is negative. Black is also negative. Okay? Right. Black wire to green wire. Twist, and twist it good. Look, twist it like you're playing Twister. Don't act like you don't know what that game is. What those apes do on that game, honestly. Haven't you guys got something better to do? Well, after this, you should, as that. You can buy a high voltage generator, experiment yourself. It's not legal because many people use other high voltages for EMPs and stuff like that. The police use them all the time. Oh no, that's the wrong high voltage generator. Battery case. Oh my god. I don't have batteries, I have a square battery. But yes, black wire to red wire. No, sorry. Black wire to green wire, okay? And then red wire to another red wire. And what you're buying here, on this analogy, is a battery case with a switch. Battery case with a switch. Do you get it? Please, can you say yes so I can stop humiliating you? Right, thank you. Jesus. You mortals. Anyway, this will wrap up my video. I'm very sorry that I didn't get to do the last analogy. I somehow misplaced the battery case with a switch. This right here requires batteries, which I do have downstairs, but I don't really want to go downstairs right now. Yes, actually, just to show you it does work, I don't want to make out that I'm lying. Come on, right, wrong way. Oh, let's just get a close up view. Obviously, with this iPad, or whatever I'm using to film, it's not very good at capturing it at low speeds. So, yeah. But that's how to make a taser. I really do recommend using a button because it's a lot more safer. If you use a lot more high voltage than you were expecting, you can actually let go. Whereas with a switch, if you use something on like a wrist and you were going to switch it on and off using a switch, then that's going to be a lot more harder. Whereas this, you have to actually press it down. Whereas the other switch, you just leave it on and it leaves it on. So please do use this. This is a lot more safer. It may require more components, but honestly, it's very cheap, the components. I'll put it in the description of the list that the things you will need and the list of analogies which of the components. Thank you very much for joining The Inventor, and please and always keep your life interesting.